You guys have been partying big time, huh? Right? So I'm going to keep that. I couldn't believe it. It was like destiny. You walked out of the car and it was literally on your foot.
I thought it was a real silver charm and I was very excited.
It was one of those glitter things. But so before we get started, I wanted to mention, in order to get as many of your questions answered as possible, if you have one, please tweet at Katie Show, at BlogHer, and Momo will text me questions as they come in, okay? So, Katie.
Yes, Anita.
A new show. Yeah. On September 10th, you'll launch your new show in the afternoon day part. It is the only day part left that you haven't dominated. Why are you doing it? What's going on
about that? And I guess, I'm not sure if I'm trying to be a daytime dominatrix or not, but, I'm very excited. I think this is a new chapter for me, a new beginning, a new adventure, and I'm just really thrilled to be in a venue where I can really be myself, and I think in terms of what I bring to the table, my skill set is really interacting with people, trying to sort of distill complicated topics, trying to really get the best out of people when I'm talking with them and doing an interview with them, and trying to deliver really useful information to the public. So the idea of being able to start from scratch, to have a blank canvas, and to be able to create a one-hour show where I can spend an hour if I feel it's justified on any given topic or talking to a newsmaker or celebrity, it's just really exciting for me. And the idea that I have sort of, I wanted to feel like a community, very much like you guys are a community. I wanted to feel like an inclusive conversation with a lot of different points of view, but most importantly, I want to respect the audience because I feel like there are a lot of smart women out there who aren't really finding enough there, really anywhere sometimes on television. I think a lot of subjects are getting short shrift. And I think, see, all the smart women are clapping. Come on, I think we should hear a bigger round of applause for that. I have really smart friends who are very engaged and interested and curious, and sometimes I just don't know if they're being served quite enough with the current fare that's being offered. That's not to say a lot of people aren't doing great shows that are really fun to watch and interesting and entertaining, but I think there's always room for more, and always room for more smart conversations about a whole wide variety of topics. And I think, the idea of flexing my muscles and being able to explore, do an hour interview with someone like Hillary Clinton about her role as Secretary of State and what she's learned along the way, doing something on military suicide, which happened at a rate of 1 day, and post-traumatic stress and what is actually working and are we serving our veterans as well as we should be. But also doing fun topics too, and we're doing a whole show on hair, which I think is going to be sort of fun. What's that down there? All right. So sometimes we'll do lighter topics, sometimes more fun. I have I think because of my personal life experiences, I've learned a lot along the way, but I feel like I still have so much to learn. And whether it's raising teenage daughters, which is, as you know, really difficult, or caring for an aging parent, which I'm doing with my own mom. My dad passed away last summer, and so, my siblings and I are trying to do our best with helping our mom, to over-parenting. That's my new obsession, sort of this whole notion that we're all doing too much for our kids and raising a generation of really young people who don't have enough of a sense of purpose. So I'm interested in that topic and cultural trends and how technology is affecting our relationships. The fact that 1 in 4 couples over the age of 50 are now divorcing. I think it was 1 in 10 back in the early 90s. And so that brings up the whole topic of, creating a new life for yourself after divorce or, after you become a widow, as I became when I was 41. So, there are so many different things that I think we all kind of are interested in, even if it may not have to be happening to us personally. I think a lot of people can relate to the topics we're going to be exploring on the show.
Well, I mean, you're mentioning everything from PTSD to widowhood and the multimedia format that you and I were discussing backstage and the way you're planning to use social media. Do you want to talk about that a little bit? Because I think it's pretty innovative. I mean, it's really built in.
Well, I think that we, you know, I feel like social media, I can't even call it new media anymore, but social media obviously is here to stay, and I'm someone who comes from traditional media who's really tried to embrace it because I started doing it when I was at CBS because doing the evening news was really a privilege for me, and I felt very honored to be sitting in a chair that was once occupied by Cronkite. You know, so I was, you know, absolutely thrilled. Plus, I thought it was a very important symbol, not only for young women, but for young men to see that a woman on her own could do that job confidently. Yeah,
first woman and
I had time to ask one reporter a question, you know, they had 15 seconds to answer, and I'd say, thanks very much, and on to the next thing, even though I probably had a lot more questions that I wanted to ask. But I think when I was doing that job, I felt a little separated from, you know, people in the audience. And I think unlike the Today Show, where, you know, people used to come up to me and say, I feel like I know you, and I would say, well, you actually do. You know, you've seen me have two kids on TV, you've seen me lose my husband to cancer and my sister to cancer. You've seen me in situations that have been very difficult in terms of interviewing people who've gone through experienced tragedy. You've seen me fly across the plaza as Peter Pan. I mean, you've kind of seen all sides of me, and so you really do. But I didn't feel that connection when I did the evening news with people because it was so, you know, people, when they first started watching me, I think they thought I had a lobotomy or something because I never smiled and I couldn't really be that animated. And I'm kind of an actually chicken animated person. And so I started doing Twitter because it was really fun for me to hear from people. And then I started doing a web show, a web-only interview show once a week because I could have this kind of experience and this kind of interaction and pick the subject I wanted to talk about. And it gave me just, it was very creatively liberating in a way. So I really enjoy social media, and I think it's, I don't understand when people in my business aren't kind of jumping in full, you know, feet first, because I think a lot of people are just a little uncomfortable with the whole notion. But when I think about, Lisa, how much television news has changed since I started doing it in 1979, it is just amazing. I mean, it's amazing. I don't know if you all saw the clip where Brian and I are talking about the internet. It is so embarrassing. But it was in 1994, and we're like, what is this internet thing? What does that mean thing mean? I'm like, I think it means the bad. I don't really know. And we sounded like such idiots. But I think most of you probably wouldn't have answered that question very well in 1994, either me, unless you guessed. So, but I really want social media to be a part of this new show. I don't want it to be an afterthought. I don't want things repurposed on the website. So we've created a website which is a standalone, very vibrant place where people can go, and it's going to just get bigger and bigger, we hope, where we can hear from people. We can put all sorts of different things on there, whether it's clips from the show, but it might be an article that I find interesting, or, you know, what I'm wearing that day, or who made my shoes, whatever, whatever, whatever. And, you know, where it's a really fun, vibrant place. And we're also going to have two seats for female bloggers at every show. We want them to reach out to their community. We want to hear what the community is saying, whether it's a specific, for example, if we're doing a military issue, it would be great to get input from some of the military bloggers out there. And to hear from them about some of the things, I mean, you know, this is an incredible resource for somebody like me. You know, we used to get letters when I started at the Today Show, letters from viewers saying this, that, and the other thing, often criticizing my hair, but that's okay. And, but, you know, now we can get instant feedback, we can solicit guests, we can get ideas, what are people talking about, what is their point of view on any given subject. And it's just a tremendous resource. So we're going to be doing the show every day at 2 in the afternoon. It airs in some markets at 2 and others at 3 and others at 4. But we're going to solicit questions on Twitter and Facebook in the morning so we can hear from real people and what they want to know and what they want to explore on any given day. And that's something I played with at CBS, but you know, sometimes traditional media is a little reticent to embrace social media in a really, really kind of real way. But for example, when the oil spill in the Gulf took place, sometimes, you know, get so into the weeds and into the nitty-gritty, you forget to ask the experts questions like, how much oil is down there? You know, and so we would get sometimes, I think, some of the best questions when I reached out on Twitter and asked people for their, you know, what they wanted to know.
Yeah, you really did use Twitter a lot when you were at CBS, increasingly, and you've been very active on both at Katie Show, and is at Katie Show where people should suggest story ideas?
Yeah,
volunteer.
Yeah, or just at Katie Couric, but at Katie Show, if you tweet us and you guys want to come and be part of our studio audience, either ask somebody who has a blog or just somebody who wants to come see the show, you can go to Ask Katie Couric for our website. And if you want to, I think there's no way to kind of record that right now, so if you just want to tweet the Ask Katie Show and give us your information, we can start getting people involved. And we're doing test shows next week, which is really exciting. They just finished the studio. I think they still have a few kinks to iron out, but it's really exciting, and it's 140 people in the audience. People are really close, and it's very intimate, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun, and I hope it will have some impact as well. Well, let's take a look.